Hello, and welcome to Mary Ellen Katz Plays, Stanley Parable. This has been on my radar for a while now. I didn't want to start playing it until I upgraded my graphics card, at the very least. Because I wanted the visual fidelity to be pretty nice. And I'm there now, so I wanted to just dive into this puppy. I hear it's more of an experience than like a story game, but I don't know anything about it. Is it supposed to gray out? Oh. The end is never the end. The end is never the end.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on the keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day, of every month, of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-ending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
Stanley was a cog.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Whoa. All right, so you are cog 427. Stanley. Huh? Oh. Sounds like I'm pushing buttons. I hate Mondays. Ugh, Stanley. No. No. You don't deserve a name. You are cog 427. Do I have a voicemail? No? Hey, it's almost 11:30. An hour? An hour before you... What? So you got here, what, at 10:30? Jeez, I want those hours. I guess I kind of have those hours.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Yeah, I mean, I hate Mondays. Ugh. Gotta see what everyone's up to.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Who farted? Oh my god. Partition Corp? Hilarious. Wait, so who sits here? Whose job is it to make sure everyone gets sharp pencils? It's not exactly a challenging job, but I guess 427? Yeah. Cog 427's job is not very hard either. In fact, more engaging. I just, like, killed someone's work. I like work. I just hate my boss. Ugh. This place is intolerable. This is like when I worked in a office. It was just soul reaping. Ah. That was uncomfortable. What? Door? Oh. I killed that door. Oh, okay, I guess it's one. I thought it was a mirror. I was ready to get panicked.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
What? That's fourth wall breaking. Also, who put the pot to plant next to 420? Developers, was that you? Funny joke. Okay. I'm getting some hella portal vibes. Like, no, look, see what I mean? Like, look, back there, like, you can see kind of behind the scenes a little bit. You half expect to be able to get back there just to see the inner workings of the place. Be like the Rat Man. Weaving your way to the underbelly where GLaDOS rests. Oh yeah, this is hella portal vibes. That's one I should play sometime.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Huh? Did he? Does he have to? I don't think he has to. I think that's a personal choice. And you know what? You know what? You've been telling me what to do long enough, buddy boy. We're going through the right door.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Yeah, that's... Let's check out this employee lounge. Who has ransacked this place? Alright, fiddle foul. Checking out all the things. Huh. Alright. Cool.
Ah, yes. Truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Well, I'm just gonna drink something, that's for sure. Does anyone have a quarter?
Yes. Really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it.
Hey, this... landscape? It's
at
cool.
At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy and reflected poorly on his overall personality. It's possible that this is why everyone left.
Is Stanley a stick in the mud? Also, this landscape is in portrait. That
Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue, but when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message.
It's a funny photography joke. You all hilarious.
But at last, he'd had enough of the amazing room and took the first open door on his left to get back to business.
Maybe. Maybe not. Looks pretty behind the scenes-y. Nah. What is this?
Stanley was so bad at following directions, what? It's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Okay. I mean, Stanley's broken free, man. He's a cog on the loose. Not a part of the machine anymore. You can't define what he does. Nuh-uh. He's free roaming now. Can I jump? I can duck. No jumping. Do not jump from the cargo lift while it's in motion. We've already established Stanley does not jump. Will cause death. Will it? I mean, that's pretty deadly. That looks pretty deadly. Also, chain link fence, chest high. I'd like to see some chest-high shooters use that for cover. Ha ha! Ha ha. Okay.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
What?
I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not.
Are you talking?
I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
Has it?
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about.
Is it me?
Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Who? It still could be me. Are we talking about me? Probably not talking to me.
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life.
Me?
She's been waiting.
The developers probably assumed that a guy would play this, so it's probably not me. It's just how it goes. The dark room. It's a very, very dark room. Hi, dude, Jesus!
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
That's a power outlet, not a phone line. Morpheus, is that you?
Sweetie, sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your day.
GLaDOS?
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
I don't appreciate that trickery. So, no. We out.
Sorry, but you're in my story now.
But I am in the Matrix. What trickery is this? Oh.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
What? Good morning, employee 428. Press B on your keyboard. No. No. Refuse. I refuse. This is me pressing the mouse button. Mouse 1, as a matter of fact. Refuse to press B. Refuse to press everything else but B. You can't jump. I just earned the achievement, you can't jump. Okay. You probably didn't see that, but that's all that. It's an achievement. You can't jump. Nope, I can totally duck though. I can duck. Fine.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
What? Inconsequential? I don't like that. Okay. No. I refuse to press that one. I press the other ones. Z. I'll press Z all day. Trying to break me, aren't you?
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Wait, has that desk always been there? Okay.
But in his mind, in his mind, he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
OK. Okie dokie.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth. The thought excited him terribly.
I would like to spend some time with the boys.
So he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Yeah, man. Yeah, let's prepare some dinner.
As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
Game with a baby? All right. Something about mind control was in there? All right. Kids, let me tell you a story about Employee 427. Stanley.
It was such a wonderful fantasy, and so in his head, he relived it again, and then again, and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
I love you, baby.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets, the more he forgets which life is the real one.
I am really sleepy now.
And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
I'm with you on this one, man. Press A to be at work in the morning? Man, as we've established, I hate Mondays. So, yeah. Can't not.
You see?
Oh.
Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself?
Oh.
How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
I am Bender. Insert girder.
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time.
Maybe.
And I tried again.
What?
And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried.
Oops. Well, here we are, back again. I don't know what to make of that.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Yeah. A memo. 429, 428, those are my compadres. My
no
best.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Yeah, they're plumb gone, man. Plumb gone. Guess we gotta keep going. Keep on trucking. Before this turns into CS
when
office.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Yeah, I mean, clearly the door on the right was the wrong choice.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Nuh-uh.
Wow. Yes. This room. What a beautiful room.
Hush.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nuh-uh. As a matter of fact, that's not how
Stanley
it goes
so
at all.
Bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
There, I happen to notice that truck down there. I'ma fall down there. Just to see, one, will it cause death? I mean, we freaking matrixed out of here, up there.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not.
I'm not so sure about that.
I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
Yeah, I'm sure.
To someone you've been...
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it.
Huh?
Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
Okay, all right. You got a chance, man. You got a chance. Everyone deserves a chance, but the whole, like, trickery with the room and shit, that shit don't fly. Danger everywhere. Crab baskets. Alright, now we feel like we're in the back rooms, the behind the scenes, the inner cogworks of the game. I don't know about this whole door closing business.
Now listen carefully, this is important.
Okay.
Stanley walked through the red door.
Did he? Alright. I mean, that's the door on the left, right?
Aha. Perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door.
Oh, how silly of me. I mean, of all the choices, red is clearly the right choice.
I still don't think we're communicating properly.
Oh.
Stanley walked through the red door.
Oh, the red door. Like, why didn't you say something before? Like, you could have just said the red door and I would have gone through the red door. You could have just said something, man. Why don't you just say something?
All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You
Whoa.
See? There's nothing here.
Whoa.
I haven't even finished building this section of the map, because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you?
A story?
I think I put a lot of time into that, because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing, because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what, let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
Okay. I'm down to give it a shot. I mean, you're going off the beaten path here? Let's go together.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's pretty cool. It's pretty, yeah. But sure, you know what? You know what? You're trying. You're trying, man. And I can't wait to see you more. Can't wait to see more, man. Yeah. But you're not trying that hard.
Okay, so we're getting somewhere. Clearly there's something here that speaks to you. If I can be honest here, I really don't have any idea where I'm going with this. This whole third door thing was just a stab in the dark. But I guess you're into it, so let's keep this party train rolling.
Choo-choo!
Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
All right. Oh. The Stanley Parable World Leaderboard. What? All right. In total, doors open, doors attempted, steps taken. Oh, wow. Awards won. Really? You can win an award. Did you know that 21% of players skip the intro to cutscene? Oh. This is 9,328th. What is that? I have most certainly not been playing 7 hours. Thank you. Why not ask some friends for help? Error, friendless, empty, what the shit? Oh my goodness. Did you know 21% of players skipped the intro cutscene? Only the worst 3% of players chose the blue door. 98%, okay. A dead rat is offline. This is your superior. Holy shit, man. Holy shit. Okay. That's some good stuff.
Would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again, honest answers, please.
Hell yeah, man. We gotta beat a dead rat. That shit is... competitive.
Hey, I forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you?
No,
perfect.
Man. Hit me.
Let me boot it up. In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game, all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
But, wait, this is a game about a baby? Okay, yeah. So far, I'm crushing it. But I really want to know one thing. What is up with this potted plant? This thing is really just kind of standing out here.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me?
No,
the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas.
No,
I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try.
But
I'm out.
No,
I'm done.
This...
it's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see.
No,
what
the
do we have here?
The potted plant. It's so random. It was so random.
Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
What?
Well, Stanley, is this any better? At last, the one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with. But is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough? Well, I'll say this. I'm done making things for you. From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater artistic purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house.
Did you really boot up Minecraft? Like, did you really do that?
This will go here. No, here. And then... let's see, what does it need? Yes, of course. And just to finish it all off... yes, it's complete.
This is awful.
Stanley, look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy. Ah, but you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience. Please, step inside and make yourself comfortable.
Oh my god, this is actually Minecraft. I'd be really interested to know if it accessed actual Minecraft assets or if it's just a part of the Stanley Parable. But this... is awful. This is a terrible mud hut.
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect? It could only be better if... Wait, that's it. We must rebuild it out of diamond. Diamond everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Like some kind of crystal-obsessed Donald Trump, I guess. Ugh. Well, still can't jump. That's a problem. Nope, alright. I can't run. That's not the Minecraft music.
Oh my, it looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light?
Oh. Man, I would like to get over there, though. I guess we're going deeper. And, I hope you can see. It's really dark, but it's not like Minecraft dark. Like, I don't have any torches or anything like that to make the experience better for everyone.
Oh, no, 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 no. This is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all. 1 out of 5.
No.
Even the diamonds couldn't save this one.
No.
Okay, new game.
Uh-oh. What?
Yes! I don't even know what this game is, but I love it.
I approve.
Trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
It's a great time is what it is. Yeah, man. Aperture science all up in here. Yeah! This is the best, the grooviest tune. I get to carry the radio. I get to go through the... Oh, I get to push buttons.
Oh, it's a puzzle. Critical thinking, Stanley. Your forte.
Yeah, man. All right, yeah. That's cool. I can dig. Set that there. We're gonna do this.
Genius.
I'm gonna go on an awesome adventure, you and I, Mr. Radio, and also, narrator, man. Yeah.
No,
yeah.
Actually, you know what? I think that's plenty. I really don't care much to see you stumble through any more of these games.
What?
And I highly doubt you're any wiser for the experience. Which is why, rather than continue to waste my time, I'm just going to leave you here.
No.
You can
pretend
you've beaten the game if it makes it any richer for you, but as for me, I've had enough.
But...
So, why don't you get cozy in this room, and if you have any grand revolutionary ideas for the perfect video game, you can just sit there and let it ball up inside you for all eternity.
No.
I don't need your advice.
I
don't need your ratings.
What?
And I certainly don't need the validation of a man whose job is to push buttons. I think I'll just go about my business, making meaningful cultural contributions to the world. And perhaps every now and then, I'll think back to a man named Stanley who was objectively wrong in every decision he ever made.
But...
The thought won't last long. Goodbye, Stanley. Good luck with your work. And I sincerely hope that everyone lives happily ever after.
Huh? Bye. Some groovy-ass tunes. Well, I guess we have one choice. I hope this hole doesn't kill us. Oh no, I think it broke my radio. Ooh. This place is freaking dusty. Oh man, work in progress. Filing cabinets here. It is dark. And... Oh. Okay. Oh no. Hey, I can see it. I dropped my radio. Well, it did just kind of turn off, so I guess there's really no more use to it. Oh dear. Oh. Is this developer hell? Is this where you go when you're Half-Life 3? Duke Nukem? The Phantom? I understand Duke Nukem was released eventually, but you kind of wish that it wasn't. Yeah, man. This looks like developer hell. A real place where developers go. And I guess games, too. Unfinished. I mean, The Phantom wasn't a game, but, it certainly was The Phantom. It was never finished. But man, was it hyped up. Is it just this little area? Okay, you know what? Let's go get our radio. Oh dear, oh dear. Goodbye, radio! Huh? Oh. Okay. We landed. Is this Silent Hill? 510. Okay. Alright, sure. No problem. 508. Yeah, this is normal, right? Yeah. It's good. It's good. It's just creepy as hell. Dark rooms. Just darkness everywhere, honestly. Can you see? I can barely see. Like, I almost want to crank up my, brightness for your sake. Oh, here we go. Here we go. 423. Close to my number. Hey! Alright. Alright, sure. Ah, warm light. There's my number. Hello, Mission Control. And just push everything, including the big blue monitor. Oh, that actually looks like a surveillance room of some sort. Why does everything sound like a button push? I mean, I guess that's what I'm doing. I'm pushing mouse one. Therefore, a button. Alright. Cool. I guess that's that. I did it. Nope.
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice, and if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon. I can wait.